What's up, beautiful people? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Blexynorji, as you know, and if this is your first time here, you're welcome. And if you've been here before, thank you for coming back. So in today's video, we'll be talking about the important things that single ladies need to know. I just thought that this is the best time to talk about these things, especially now that is this festive period that people are traveling and you're getting to meet a lot of people. So I think this is really important for us to know these things and also remind ourselves that these things are things we should take into consideration. And this video was inspired by Padita Agu's video where she talked about how she got married to a man she met for the first time. So guys, if you want to know what we'll be talking about in this video, please keep on watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that already, and turn on your post notifications so you don't miss out on any of my uploads. Guys, I am trying to do this Vlogmas thing and where I'll be posting every day till Christmas. I don't think I'll be doing a lot of vlogs. Like, I don't think I'll be doing only vlogs. I want to do random things, maybe fun videos, talk videos, and vlogs also, and food and all of that. So you guys should please stay tuned, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that already, and turn on your post notification. And yeah guys, I don't want to talk too much, let's get right into this video. And if you're wondering about this look right here, I have a video of it on my Instagram. It should be up by now, so please follow me. My handle is right here, so follow me and check it out. And yeah guys, let's get right into the video. So like, I mean business. I wrote everything down in my book because I don't want to forget anything. This is so important that I don't want to forget anything. So this video is mainly just to avoid like single ladies getting into the wrong marriages, or even getting into the wrong hands, maybe just dating or something. So the first one I'll be talking about is, don't expect too much from anybody. Like, it's not every man that talks to you this festive period wants a serious relationship or wants to even get married to you. Some of them just want to have fun, some of them just want to enjoy that city, and they need a girl, a boo, to run the party together. And don't fall into their hands, please, girl. You don't want to be heartbroken at the end of the whole celebration thing, the whole December period. You'll be heartbroken, or even in general. So what I'm saying here is, please take your time, get to know the person, get to know the person's intentions first before even deciding to invest your time and your heart into it. And yeah, the second thing I'll be talking about is, never get married to someone you just met online without taking our time to get to know that person. I have seen situations whereby people would just be like, oh, I met him and we got married within 1 week or within 2 weeks or something like that. It's really not advisable. It's really not advisable. I see a lot of stories on social media where people talk about how they met through DMs, through comment section, and it just sounds so sweet, so pleasing to hear. But the truth is that it might not even end as beautiful as they make it sound. I'm not trying to wish anybody bad here, but the truth is that not everything that works for someone might work for you. You get what I'm saying? So you have to be careful. Get to know this person first. This is not just for people who meet online. This is also for people who are meeting like in person. I've seen situations whereby you meet someone one time, probably the person travels or something, and you guys just continue your communication online. From that place, you guys just decide to take things to the next level and probably start preparing for your wedding, start working towards getting married, and before you know it, boom, marriage happens. You don't even know the person. You don't even know him. All you know is his name, you know his family, you know this, you know that, and you don't know who he is truly, which is like the wrongest thing to do. You need to know someone. I know it's not possible to get to know someone, but you need to try to get to know that person as much as you can. Get all the possible data you need, anything that you know, okay, this is something I cannot deal with, this is something I cannot handle. You need to take your time, check if that person has those things that you cannot deal with, so you know what you can work with and what you can, like, you know what you can overlook and what you cannot overlook. Like, you get what I'm saying? So you guys, you need to take your time, like, relax. Nobody's rushing you. This is a forever something. Nobody's rushing you. Take your time. Like, I don't want to know about all this time that people are giving us. Like, just take your time and get to know somebody. Because I know they say women have, like, time and all those things. I don't know if it's true. But if you force it, if you rush it, what if you don't get what you want at the end of the day? Are you getting married to just, like, leave in pain, in worries, and in agony? Like, it's not what you want right here. So I think you should take your time, get to know who you're getting married to, get to know who you're committed with or to. So you really need to take your time. And another thing I'll be talking about in this video is, don't let people pressure you. I feel like one of the biggest things that pushes you to, like, look for whoever that comes your way, like, pressure could come from anybody. Pressure could come from your family, pressure could come from friends, pressure could come from social media. Like, you go online, you see all these people getting married, you see all these wedding gowns, and you're like, where's my boo? You go home, your mom is like, I need my grandchildren, and all those things. One thing I need to remind you guys is, it's your life. It's your life. Like, don't let anybody pressure you. Don't. That's the worst thing ever. If you're not ready for it, don't force yourself. Don't force things to happen. Take your time. Like, take your sweet time. Find the right person and get married. It's not how fast, it's how well. Like, you might just get married the next day, and the next 2 days you're out of it, and people who waited 10 years will just get into the right marriage and be chilling, sipping wine every morning, afternoon and night, and you're there crying and all those things. Don't let age pressure you. Don't let anything, as long as that person is not the right person for you, or you're not just bonding with that person, don't just say, oh, I can do it, oh, it doesn't matter, it's not looking at me, it's not attending to me, I can deal with it. Baby, cannot. Because the moment you get into that marriage, that is when you understand how much you love attention. That is when you understand some of the things that maybe you feel, if you're the kind of person that can stay one whole day without talking to anybody. That is when you start finding out that you cannot deal with it. If you don't see anybody, if you don't see your husband, or if you don't see your love, the next second you're already being, like, worried and all those things. You have to be with the right person, the person that loves you. Don't let pressure push you into doing the wrong thing. Don't let social media, don't let your parents, even your parents, like, nobody should force you into doing what you don't want to do. Because parents, sometimes it's like you don't want to fail your parents, you're so worried about what your mom would think of you, what your father would think of you. But the truth is that they will not be there. Like, they will not be there for you they will not be there to fight for you. If this thing doesn't go well, they will not be there. They'll be like, go and deal with it, we are dealing with our own. So you have to take your time. The next one I'll be talking about is, be with someone you trust and someone you can trust. This is really important, because if you don't trust someone you're getting married to, why are you even going there? Like, if you don't, why are you going there? If the person you're getting married to doesn't trust you, why should you even be there with them? See, getting married to them does not mean they will trust you. You feel me? Getting married to them does not mean they will trust you. I've seen situations whereby you get married to someone and the person still does not trust you. If you're going out, he's so worried, where are you going to, who are you talking to on the phone, he wants to, like, cut you off with your friends, he wants to tell you what to do, who to talk to, why to talk to people. Like, you don't need that kind of person. Be with someone that can trust you, and someone you can also trust. Because you cannot be with someone that you're also not sure about his whereabouts. You cannot, like, let him go out without being worried, without being worried about things that will go on out there. So be with someone you trust with, like, it's very important. I see a lot of people like so interested in getting married to people who stay outside Nigeria. Like, it's just a thing. Like, I don't know why. I used to be like that, but till I saw the reality of things, like, I've seen reality of not everybody. I'm not like generalizing it though. Some people are real, some of them are not. I feel like this one has a lot of things that, like, this particular topic has a lot of things under them. First of all, if you're getting married to someone who stays abroad, like, who is based there, don't be carried away with that abroad. Don't be. The first thing you need to be sure is you love this person. Is this person ready to take you out there with him? That is very important. You need to talk about it. Don't act like, don't say, oh, I don't want him to think I am desperate. As long as you guys have started talking about marriage, you need to talk about that other side of it. You need to ask him, guy, are you taking me out there, or am I going to just be chilling in Nigeria answering obodo ibo wife without crossing borders? You need to ask questions. Another thing is, if the person tells you, oh, I am married but it's just for papers, see, and he's still in that marriage at that point and still trying to tie you down, don't let that happen. Because the moment you do that, which means you're not going out there with him. Some of them are married for papers, no doubt, but some of them are actually not. They are there for love. They are there because they like the person, not for papers, not for what they are going to get from you, but because of their love for that person. Maybe the person's parents have just been on their neck asking them for a wife and they want to just marry you and keep you in the house. These things still happen. It's as crazy as it may sound, they still happen. I have seen them happen to people and it is still going to happen. If you're not careful, it's going to happen. But I'm really hoping that this video helps someone out there. If you're like that person who is worried, who is so concerned about getting married to someone who stays out there, please take your time so you don't get into the wrong hands. Please take your time. It's really important to take your time. These people, some of them are not as real as they claim to be. Please take your time. Take your time. You have to be sure of what the person does. Like, if you're getting married to anybody, be sure of what the person does. Be sure of, just ask questions. Ask as much question as you can ask. Ask. Ask about the person's background. This thing, see, there is no time to rush things. If you keep saying you're rushing, and you leave something out, then when the problem comes, you have to face it. And nobody has time, like, to be facing problems in this life. Like, life alone gives you enough problem. Don't give yourself another one to deal with. Like, it's not allowed. It's not acceptable here. So ask questions so you don't end up marrying your brother. Worst case scenario. What am I saying? Ask questions about people so you don't end up marrying someone you're not supposed to marry. These things still happen, no? Ask question. Ask. Be with someone who respects you. I feel like at this point, everybody understands what respect is. You understand what respect is. Be with someone who respects you. Test the person you are with. Test that person. Push all the buttons you can push. I know that this might sound crazy, because how would she be telling me to annoy my man? How would she be telling me to annoy somebody just to be sure if that person is right? But it's very important to get to know these people. Know if that person is the type of person that will beat you if he's angry, or is the type of person that will just throw things, or is the type of person that will just walk away from the situation. It's very important to get to know all these things so you not get into trouble. These days we talk about domestic violence, we talk about all these things. Please get to know that person. There are so many dangers in just being careless, just being ignorant. There's so many dangers that comes with ignorance. So please ask questions. take your time to get to know people. Like everything I'm talking about here is still bouncing back to taking your time. You still need to take your time to do all these things. Please don't rush it. Don't rush it. If it means like writing out a list of things you need to know that you need to take into consideration when meeting somebody, please do that so you don't miss anything. And another thing I'll be talking about is there is nothing you can do like on earth without speaking to God about it, especially marriage. Marriage is something that is too deep that you cannot just embark on that journey without speaking to God. It is very important you speak to God. It is very important to pray about things. I know a lot of people tell you follow your feelings, follow your heart. I'm not telling you to go and meet anybody to pray for you, to give you a husband, to tell you who to marry. I am telling you to go on your knees, pray to God. Just pray about things, because you really need to talk to God. God will definitely show you a sign. And the thing is not just, it's not about praise, not just about praying. It is about you being ready to listen. Because sometimes God shows us signs. Sometimes God talks to us. Are you ready to hear him? Are you ready to do what he asked you to do? What if he tells you he's not the one? Are you going to leave the person? Or you're going to say, God, I will do it my own way. You have tried your own side. Let me do my own. You have to be ready to listen. Even if you like the person as much as you do, if God tells you no, it is a no. Don't. Just let him go. And he is going to send you the right person. Before you get married, it is very important for you to have something doing. It is very important to have something you can do, something that pays you, something you're getting money from. Don't just sit down and be looking for someone to do it for you. Even if you're a housewife, even if you decide that you want to be a housewife, now we have housewife. The housewife we have now is not the one we used to hear about. So many of the housewives now that you've been hearing about, they are in their house cashing checks. They are there making boss moves. Don't just sit at home and do nothing. Look for something doing. There are a lot of jobs you can do online now. There are a lot of things you can just do by sitting in your room, sitting wherever, just doing your work and receiving paychecks. Don't just sit at home. Please get something doing. Don't be a liability. Because trust me, the moment you keep asking for everything, they're going to get tired. Like, they will get tired of you. So you need to help yourself and help the people around you by getting something to do. This is very important. Very important. Not that you get something to do and you don't ask your husband for something, but not that everything you ask for, not everything you ask for, but you need to get something doing. Very important. Like, it's either you get a skill, just learn something. No knowledge is a waste. Just get something, anything you love doing, start working on it. Be with someone who brings out the best in you. That is another thing. Be with someone who brings out the best in you. Don't just be with someone who is always condemning everything you do. Someone who thinks you're nothing. Someone who thinks you can do nothing. Even if you're working, there are some people who still look at you like, is it not this thing you're doing? I beg you, look for someone who is ready to, even with the knowledge you have, who is ready to like make you see even better opportunities and all of those things. So yeah guys, I think I have said all that I have to say in this video. Please, if there's anything I did not mention in this video that you know about, please let us know in the comment section. I will be reading the comments. I also want to learn a lot of things, so please, if you know anything, please feel free to leave them in the comment section. And yeah guys, thank you all for listening to me today, and I hope this video really helped someone out there. Drop your comments down below. Oh, I already said that. And like this video, please give me a huge thumbs up. Like this video. You see that thing like this that shows something like this, please like it. I don't want no dislike here. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel and turn on your post notifications so you don't miss out on any of my uploads. Until my next one guys, I'll see you all tomorrow. I'll see you all soon. Bye. Is it me or is it she? Because we're two different people and
I would never treat you like she did in the past.